Welcome everybody to this event. I'll be moderating this with Nancy Hayden from Sandia and a good friend Bernardo Madero from University of Colorado Boulder. I'm working on this for at least 3 years since we organized the first Global Peace Engineering Conference. So this is the definition that we came up in November 2018 and this is the one we started to use since November 2018, which is the first Global Peace Engineering Conference. And you can, but the definition is, I just want to repeat myself, we're trying to get rid of silos and have everybody contribute and work together for common cause. Climate change is one of them and many, many grand challenges that we have. And this is also coming up with new solutions, and this is what engineers do. So like I said, we've been working this 3 years ago. These are some of the members of the Peace Engineering Consortium. There's institutions, academic institutions, corporations, NGOs, et cetera, very committed to making this peace engineering happen. So with the peace engineering folks, we meet every Friday at 9 a.m. Mountain Time to discuss and plan things and brainstorm what should we do with curricula for research, with how do you finance peace, what's the policy, so on and so forth.
As Romero said, the peace engineering effort has really got kicked off with the Global Engineering Deans Conference in 2018, and they established this Peace Engineering Consortium. There was a lot of participation at very high levels from Sandia National Laboratories as well as Los Alamos. And Sandia took to heart their commitment at a high level of looking at peace engineering and what it could mean. And we did some internal searches to see how it really fit with our mission as a nuclear weapons laboratory, just to put that right on the table. Some people asked about that. And what we realized is that this, you know, Sandia's purpose is to advance science and technology to advance peace in the world. And that's done through many different avenues. Some is security building and some is sustainable development and the science and technology and engineering to support that. And peace engineering really provides a holistic framework for doing that. And so within Sandia, we engaged our academic alliance partners, many of whom are on the Zoom call right now. We participated with the consortium at Drexel and Stanford and others, and reached out and engaged other organizations and really made a commitment this last year. These efforts culminated in an institutional letter of support from our chief research office to help UNM kick off their Peace Engineering Center and to be a partner and collaborator in this effort. On the way to doing that, we engaged George Rowe in the new DOE office of Arctic Security, and some of the programs at Sandia really put themselves forward out of the climate air program to be exemplars as the material sustainability and some of the computing for how peace engineering can make a difference in the way we do business. And that's some of what you'll hear about today. And we're looking forward to seeing how we go forward now with the consortium and UNM and making the peace engineering effort really progress substantially. So.
Thank you, Nancy. This is something great happened with the National Academy of Engineering. They came up with their new strategic plan at the beginning of this month. And I think this is aligned with the work we've been doing for the past 3 years in peace engineering, all the discussions, exchanges, brainstorming. So I think what we have done is matches perfectly with this that strategic plan of NAE has to say. And I'm gonna stop here and we're gonna start with the different presentations. And Bernard, if you can introduce Joe.
Can I introduce Joe? I want to thank Ramiro and his team for putting this workshop together. 2018, I had the privilege of attending the conference. 3 years later, here we are. Feels like, peace engineering, I know you're going to laugh about it. It's like an elephant in the room. It's a huge elephant, and we won't touch it. You know, this the story of the blind man touching the elephant. is looking for the elephant. Yeah, he is here, actually. And we're all looking at it and say, oh, yeah, this engineering is this, this engineering is that. And hopefully at the end of this conference, we'll have a pretty good idea that what the elephant is and how we can proceed forward.